in attracting individuals to the service. And this has a lot to do with what we talked about with part of the sanctuary, with the open door, its beautiful colors, it's never being closed, it's wide expanse of it. We're the open door that allows people to come in to see Jesus. So we're going to go through the training. We're going to learn how to say things. We're going to learn how to look at each other. Amen. Amen. We're going to learn how to do various ministries. Because you're not just going to come and sit.
Man.
Oh, let's get quiet, buddy. You're not going to come and sit.
Yes, sir.
We are going to be actively involved in this series. There to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Are you happy?
That you are in Christ Jesus, who has become for us mercy, his child and forever.
Thank you.
God give you. We're going to sing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for he is good. As the ushers play upon us right now.
Thank you.
Our hearts are troubled. There is fear in the land. There are shootings almost every day. Our big cities, Lord, are not safe. One can travel to foreign lands and have to look constantly over their shoulders. Bombings and strife. Terrorism at every hand. And one wonders just how long this will continue. But you have given us a promise, an assurance of faith, that when we see these things, we're not to run around with people who have lost their minds. We are to but look up, because we know that salvation draws nigh.
Yes.
To be able to stand there and cry out, "Oh, this is..." We pray for our President Barack Obama and his wife Michelle. We pray for his two daughters who are growing up right before our eyes. We pray for the security team that surrounds him. We pray for the men and women of Congress who must be about their country's business. We pray for the men and women in uniform, those who stand on freedom frontier in far-flung places to ensure that we have peace and stability in this place as we prepare our hearts and our minds for you. Finally, Father, we look forward to that day when you have promised to return, to take each one of us back to live with you.
Yeah.
There those 1,000 years in glory, and then to return to this earth made new, to reestablish, rebuild, replant, and to live with you for all eternity. This is our prayer at this time, in this place, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We learned that the fire that burned there consumed.
flower.
We found out also that the horns on the altar symbolize the blood of Calvary that reached into the four corners of the earth, that even if you couldn't get to Calvary, Calvary could make it to you.
Amen.
We found out that the altar is God accepting us and doing for us what we cannot do for ourselves.
Amen.
Today, we will examine the third aspect of grace in the sanctuary as found in the labor. The labor in Greek is translated lotra, and it means bath or washing.
Man.
We found out in our Wednesday night prayer meeting that this was the place where the priests would wash their hands and their feet during service at the altar. We're going to look at its placement right now because how it is placed speaks a lot about how God interacts with each one of us. You see, the laver is located behind the altar and not in front. Grace does not leave you as you are found. The door says, with me.
Amen.
You say grace cleans you up. It washes away the filth. Yes. You see, you come in to the court through the open gate, and there is Christ forgiving you of your sin. Yes. The sins are consumed. They're done away with.
When I was a farmer, well, I should say when my dad was a farmer, and I lived on a farm. I had the pleasure and privilege of learning how to operate farm equipment. My dad and his brother, who had an adjoining farm, had massive tractors, quad axle tractors, with 12 bottom plows. The calves were air conditioned with AM FM radio. And that's how I learned to operate a tractor, was on the older tractor before he let me migrate to the air conditioned cab tractor. And I would be out there in the fields, and my dad would plow. He'd have a 12-bottom plow in front of me, and I'd be behind him with the disc. And this was a massive disc, because when you went down the road with it, you had to raise the sides so the cars could go by.
Of regeneration, the labor, yes, of
can do.
Amen.
This is known as sanctification.
Amen.
This is known as sanctification. The setting apart of what Christ died for, that he might sanctify and cleanse it. Talking about us. With the laundering, the washing of water by his word.
Amen.
See, my friends, God sets us aside. That's what sanctified means.
Man.
You hear people around, I'm a born-again, sanctified Christian. What they're really saying is, I've been justified and now I've been set aside. That's what sanctification means. Sometimes we in the household of faith get it all backwards. We're talking about trying to be sanctified our entire life. But the Bible says we've been sanctified through the washing. When you went down into baptism, you were sanctified. You were set aside. When you studied his word, you are sanctified. You are set aside. You have been given a special purpose. We've been sanctified, which means set aside. This is sanctification. We were sanctified when we were baptized. We were sanctified through his blood.
Man.
That he might sanctify. That word sanctify in Greek means from a particular point in time and then it ends. You were sanctified. I went to the store. I turned off the television. I went to sleep. He sanctified me by his own blood.
Well, somebody say hallelujah.
Sanctification means to be set aside. You see, God has a purpose for us. If you got your Bible, go ahead, turn with me. This text is not on screen, but it's a very important text. 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. Jesus and have been fed, and now we go and find someone else who says, you know what? We're to minister to others around us because we are a holy, a pure. In fact, the Greek word for holy means clean. You know why we're clean? Because the Bible said you've been washed. You've gone through the labor and been cleaned up. We're the holy nation. Sanctification is equal to being made clean. A holy priesthood set aside to declare the praises of God.
Amen.
The spirit of prophecy tells us this.
Amen.
Sanctification is not a show or an outside work. In other words, we can't be good long enough to become sanctified. But it is the washing, the Greek word lotrin, as translated labor or bath. It is that which is the symbol of baptism through His Word. National Testimonies to the Church, Volume 8, page 339. So when someone comes to you and says that they are a born-again Christian, you need to shout, hallelujah, because so am I.
Amen.
Acceptance by God is the open gate. Justification by God is at the altar. Sanctification by God is at the labor. It declares us acceptable. It declares us forgiven. It declares us clean.
Somebody say amen.
You see, there are three aspects of grace. Not that here. Got a little angel. Give me about 5 minutes. There are three aspects of grace throughout the sanctuary. But there is one more aspect of grace that is taught here at the labor. You see, the Seventh-day Adventist Bible commentary says that sanctification points to the marriage ritual of ancient times. You see, before the wedding, go ahead, start, go ahead. This one. Before the wedding, the bride would be given, prepared for a purified bath. Special ointments, scents, and spices would be placed in the water. Then the bride-to-be would then be immersed in the bath to prepare for the marriage. They would be sanctified, set aside for the coming wedding. You see, my friends, there is a Christ who is looking for a bride.
No.
One who went through the gate,
yes,
and was accepted as they were.
Amen.
One who went to the brazen altar and was forgiven of their sins.
Yes.
And one who went to the labor.
Yes.
The bride. See, friends, there is no magic in water. In fact, there in the sanctuary courtyard, the water became a bloody mess. There is no magic in the water. Neither was there any magic in the labor. Where there from all sin.
Yes, sir.
Someone needs to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We've been cleansed by the power of Almighty God.
Amen.
We have heard a joyful sound. Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Spread that madness all around. Jesus saves. Jesus saves. For all you've done for us, for the washing of regeneration.
Yes.
For the declaration that we are clean through your blood.
Yes.
That we have been presented as a special gift.
Yes.
As a bride to the bridegroom.
Yes.
Father, we praise you for all you've done for us in saving us from ourselves. Now, amen.